Now, we come to chapter 14, and chapter 14 has to do with the diet for God's people. We've had this before, back in Leviticus, in the 17th chapter. We've already had a reference to it here in Deuteronomy. Now we have this given again. And we have here, actually, I would say, a very clear-cut statement of it. And it might be that you find it a little clearer than it was in Leviticus. The reason for that would be that in this particular section here, why, we have this same law that we had in Leviticus tested during the wilderness march of 40 years. Now, I'm going to read, beginning at verse 1. Ye are the children of the Lord your God. Ye shall not cut yourselves, nor make any baldness between your eyes for the dead. Now, that was a heathen, pagan practice in that day. And you see the carryover of it among certain tribes today of the earth. I think that they have tribes out in Australia that are great at disfiguring their face. It's part of the worship. It's part of religion. Now, God's people were never to do that. Now, we have here the reason for the dietary laws, and he'll give them in this chapter. For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God, and the Lord hath chosen thee to be a peculiar people unto himself above all the nations that are upon the earth. Now, if you have my book on Leviticus, when we were going through Leviticus, you got that book. It would pay you to turn back there to the 17th chapter and to read about the clean and unclean animals and how this diet that God gave to his people was more than just a religious ritual, that actually there was a physical benefit by them observing it, and that it's been tested down through the centuries. Now, when the plague broke out years ago in Austria, and I have that in the book, the detailed account, that the Jewish population were not touched by the plague at all, but the rest of the people died like flies. And finally, why, of course, the anti-Semitic element, they use that as an argument. They blame the Jews for the plague. And, of course, they had nothing in the world to do with it. The thing was that they were observing the dietary law, and it is good. It has a beneficial effect. Many of the things that God had his people do not only were just religious, and here God says they're holy and they're to be a peculiar people. And believe me, this made them peculiar when a plague breaks out and they are not touched. But the wrong interpretation, of course, was placed upon it. So there is a real benefit of this diet. And we're living in a day of diets, by the way. Now, God has given a diet, not to you or me. Whether you eat meat today or don't eat meat will make no difference. That as far as your relationship to God is concerned. The thing of it is, if you observe this, you may stay in this world a little longer. And if you don't, it may get you in his presence a little quicker, by the way.